with one of our sensational shows again, of course, because we have our favorite friends in Our Souls Are Seeking. And I want you to please welcome Bishop Joe. And guess who just decided to stop by? Bishop Emmanuel. Hello.
Thank you for having us. Yes, thank you.
Yes. It's a pleasure always to see you. We missed you.
I miss all of you too as well.
Wow. And where is our young protege? Where is Sam? We have to say hello to Sam.
You know, the young generation, this is the season they are looking for.
Yes.
To make it Feliz Navidad.
I'll leave it there. I want to thank you again for praying for my grandson. He's ready to take off. He talks about you a lot. I love the younger generation because some of them have great minds. And this is one of our... a great-minded one. So he remember what you prayed about.
Wow.
Yeah, he was telling his other grandmother. He's got 4 and 5, but they do have a lot of relatives these days. But he was telling his grandmother about the prayer. She says, why wasn't I there? Why couldn't we do it? Well, we can do it again. We got 10 days.
Yes.
But anyway, thank you again.
Thank God for everything.
Hey, give us the good news.
The good news, of course, is Christmas.
It's Christmas.
So everyone is getting ready for Christmas. You know, Christ is born, given to us, a gift of God to all creation for our salvation.
Yes.
And I think that's what we are going to talk about today, the call message of Christmas.
The call's message?
The call. Yeah.
C-A-L-L.
C-O-R-E.
C-O-R-E.
Yeah.
The core.
The core. That is the heart of the message. The center.
Yeah. Okay. That's the center of Christmas. We do need to talk about that because I think we're off base.
Yes.
What do you think?
Well, of course, you know.
Of course. You can research.
Commercial interest has taken over and really we are missing the message, the real message of Christ itself unto us.
Mm-hmm.
And we probably will start out with Matthew chapter 2. You know, and from verse 1, that will probably introduce us properly into the message of Christmas.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. And you had, over the years, God our Father made a promise that the Christ will be sent for a specific task of coming to redeeming us from our sinfulness by shedding his precious blood. And by way that he will come into the world, this message was sent through Jeremiah, Isaiah, Ezekiel, Moses, and so many spoke about his arrival in the world. That's why we are having this big celebration all over the whole world now.
We're celebrating.
Yes, we are celebrating.
Okay, good.
The arrival of Christ.
Okay. Naturally, to be good for business too.
But right now in the world in 2022, commercial interest really has...
That's business.
It's business.
The spiritual side of the arrival.
Oh, that's going to be interesting to see what he says about that.
You know, whether inside the church or outside the church, it's the same.
Yes.
Whether in the Christian countries or in the non-Christian countries, it's the same. But we want to try to bring the attention of the listeners and the world at large to the core. The central message of Christmas.
That we should not forget.
That's correct.
Yes. And you know, Your Grace, the message truly for the Muslim world is so unique because in Shia Islam, their greatest patron saint is Jesus of the Healing Cross.
Yes.
He has a temple, a shrine in Iraq that every year they go there to celebrate the healing Jesus.
Yes.
So his birth is not just only for the Christian family. Even among the Hindus and the Buddhists, they regard him as the greatest personality that ever walked the earth.
Yes.
That is important because we have all of these religions.
Yes.
And so you're telling us that they all celebrate.
Yes, they celebrate Christ. Forget about the business interest.
Absolutely.
In Dubai, I think that's one of the biggest seasons, Christmas. That's when they make the highest sales. Mm-hmm. So spiritually, physically, financially, materially, and otherwise, he still remains number one.
That's a good way of putting it. The sales of souls to Christ.
It's the greatest holiday of all the holidays.
Yeah, it is.
Of all the holidays in human history, Christmas ranks number one.
Yes.
Christmas ranks number one.
Yes.
Now that's inspiring.
It is. And if you look at Christmas, it actually begins with Christ. Let's hear from Matthew chapter 2. So, this is 1 to 6.
1 through 6.
Yes,
I'm with it here. So now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these sayings, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this is the, it is written, for thus it is written by the prophet, and thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule thy people Israel."
So you can
take a governor. Rule.
Yes, yes. This is the core message of Christmas. Okay. A governor is to come out of Israel, out of Bethlehem Ephrata. That's a prophecy. The one to govern, to rule the whole universe, has been written about him, earmarked to be born in Bethlehem of Judah. Now, what do we say about this? As Christ was born, the Father revealed the star to the three wise men in the east. And seeing the star, they now track the star to Jerusalem, to go and pay homage and worship the newborn king. They made a journey of 2 years to actually go to see the newborn.
A journey of 2 years.
Yes.
Now, you think about
yes.
that. But the star was just in the east.
When Christ was born, the Father showed him them the star.
No navigation system.
Exactly.
No navigation system.
Well, today we have GPS.
Yeah, that's
right. You know the beauty of the whole thing, eh?
You know?
Even the revelation is unique.
Yes. Mm.
Christ was born in Israel.
Yes.
The wise men came from Persia.
That's right.
And Persia was the kingdom that took over from Babylon, where the Israelites were in bondage for a season under Nebuchadnezzar. And that is the present day Iran. So you can see that the whole family of man is interconnected as
that's
a
true.
Unit.
That is very true.
Abraham came from Iraq, the heir of the Chaldees. The star of the Christ was revealed in Iran, and Christ came from Israel. So you see that he came to unite all the wars that they are waging amongst each other in that region. It's a waste of energy, because the Savior connected three of them together before even he came on earth.
Yeah, it is a waste of energy.
So the Christmas,
we're still fighting about something that happened over 2,000 years ago.
But that is, if you forget your history, you will not know your future. He came to bring us together. That's why it is the greatest celebration. We have the Diwali of the Hindus. We have the Ramadan of the Muslims. We have every other festival. But no celebration is as unique as this, you know? Like he said, for God so loved the world, not the Jews alone.
The world.
The world, that he gave his only begotten son. So we ought to come together as a family to celebrate this, for remembering that we're just one family alone, the human family. That way the joy of his birth will be made manifest.
You know, I thought about, we come together as a unit, especially during, I enjoyed the World Cup immensely.
Yes, yes.
All of these worlds, all of these countries came together, and all you had was laughter and kicking a ball and the languages and all of these things that we had in on the tube.
Yes.
It was all over the world.
Yes. And it's still going on, even a few more days before it's the finals, I think it's over the weekend. So it's his entrance into the world, the entrance of Christ, is for that specific purpose, to unite the whole human race. And this is so important that he actually offered his own life. Now, if you think about it, if it's not important, if it's not that high in importance, he would not agree, accept to offer his own life as a ransom for the unity of the entirety of human race.
And you know, for that period of time, for the holiday, we really do get along.
Yes.
I mean, that's the hope. That's the spirit.
Yes.
Why can't we, can we stretch that out of it?
Well, that's the whole point. It needs to be stretched not just in the Christmas.
Right.
12 months in a year.
We do that at Christmas time, because mm-hmm. I know that one Christmas, the people that were fighting laid down their arms.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Where's the other?
And in
but even if you look at the message at his birth,
yes.
in Luke chapter 2,
yeah.
verses 10 and 11, it is very clear. He said, "And the angel said unto them, Fear not,
yes.
for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, yes. which shall be to all people. For unto you this day is born in the city of David a Savior,
yes.
which is Christ the Lord."
Tidings of great
joy. And at the end of the day, no matter how much we fight, we still come back mm-hmm. to the Word, and that is the Christ. To seek for peace, because all the wars we fight, okay, we have machines, bombs, we project, it go at megasonic speed, uproot cities and homes, and even upon all that, our naval frigates, our warships, our fighters and bombers, after the whole killing, we still gather together and call a young man to pray for us. Then we start talking peace, and the King of Peace came with the message of peace, bearing the olive branch, say, "Lean on me. Learn from me, and you shall find rest unto your soul."
Yes.
So until humanity comes to appreciate that great manifestation of the love of God and embrace that love and yes. put it into practice, we will never know peace.
That is the key, putting it into practice.
Yes.
Then we fail.
That's right. We drop the ball completely
exactly, yes.
on putting it into
practice.
Use
practice.
The word. That way, the whole wall need to pick up the ball and run with it.
Well, that's true.
Yes.
That is very true. We can, after the food and the turkey and the in-laws,
mm-hmm.
all of these things that we put together during mm-hmm. the holiday.
Mm-hmm.
But let's look again at Matthew chapter 2. What lessons we want to draw from the coming of Christ.
Mm.
As the three wise men saw the star, they made the journey into Bethlehem, and they went into the house of Herod and asked him what is the potent question of this session.
Mm-hmm.
As, where is he that is
born
king
of the Jews?
Uh-huh.
But we have seen his star. So they asked the question, where is he? So it's a he. As Christ comes into the world,
yeah.
Christ comes as a he. The male gender of the human race.
That's a very good point.
It's a central theme.
It's a
he. And a he. Not only it's a he must be born. Remember, the religious groups in Israel were expecting first Elijah
to descend from the sky.
Exactly.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah,
I remember that part.
Elijah was taken up in a chariot of fire.
Yes.
Okay.
And Malachi said that before that great day of the Lord, Malachi mm-hmm. chapter 4, verse 46,
yes.
he said, "I will send you Elijah."
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
till today, the nation of Israel, not even since that time, your grace,
yes.
up to date, they are still expecting Elijah.
Till today?
Till today.
Well, he was born.
But they didn't know that.
They refused to accept
and
that.
And they still refuse to accept
well,
that.
Let's read for you Malachi chapter 4.
Malachi 4.
5 to 6.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And he shall turn the hearts of the fathers to the children,
mm-hmm.
and the heart of the children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the earth
with a curse. Yeah.
So, this is the promise of Elijah returning.
Yeah, the curse
last time Israel saw Elijah leaving
uh-huh.
was on a chariot
of fire
into heaven.
And he had a witness.
Exactly.
Elisha.
Yes. And naturally, they expect Elijah to return the same way he left.
Right. But he did not.
Maybe this time in a chariot of smoke.
No.
And I can hear people's minds, just because mine is just ticking away like,
yes.
How is he going to return?
Exactly. So the expectation was that Elijah will return with some chariots as well.
Mm-hmm.
But Elijah returned through the womb of
a woman,
Elizabeth.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And that's the natural process of return into the earth.
You see?
Yes. That's a natural process.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also a process that everybody can understand.
Well, that's it. We all had mothers and fathers, right?
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
Today, The whole world misses the message of Christ, which is here in this question being asked by the wise men. Where is he that is born King of the Jews? Mm-hmm. Even though they saw the star in the heavens, they did not wait for him to come from the clouds. Mm-hmm. They knew that he would be born.
The prophecy had already been given to
them. This is the prophecy.
But you know,
this is the prophecy, yes.
Remember just what the Holy Father, Lido Lumbo Lumbobu, told us, remember? He said every human being is first a spirit.
Yes.
And his spirit is fire.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Flame of fire.
Flame of fire.
Yes.
Now that flame of fire, now the womb of the woman is the cooling chamber.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where that flame will be cooled, and then the spirit will be encased into the flesh. It's an encasement. This is not the spirit, but this is a container wherein the spirit manifests. Then in manifesting, after the process, it passes through the birth canal,
mm-hmm,
into existence. Christ fulfilled it. Elijah fulfilled it. Mm-hmm. All the prophets did the same.
Yes.
And you know, it makes it ironical that today we are celebrating Emmanuel, God made manifest.
Yes.
And who came through the womb of a virgin, right?
Yes.
And we're expecting the same Emmanuel again to descend from the sky. Is it not ironical?
We just don't know. I remember one of our earlier shows, we talked about the womb of a female.
Yes.
And how she can give birth to any human being.
Yes.
Oh, yes, I know, it's true. It's just amazing.
Is it?
Yes, it's just absolutely. I mean, a white, a black, a man, for a president, that
emperors,
you just never know.
Football stars.
Football stars.
Movie stars.
Yeah.
Wow.
In mystery, the woman really she is the earth giving birth to, mm-hmm, everything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You see, even though Adam was the first man that God made in the world, and instructed the rib from Adam to make a woman, the first woman came out of a man. That's the mystery of God. And thereafter, God now makes all men.
Everyone
out of
the woman,
including the Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Including the Christ, wow.
Including God Himself. Just call Him who
God
He is.
Himself.
God Himself.
Yes, exactly. That's why you are called.
Okay.
You know, they are being called the wise men. It's not for a joke. Because think about this: in the whole nation of Israel,
okay,
you have the entire ecclesiastical establishment waiting for the Christ to come from the clouds.
And yes, they have, how many years have they talked about this prophecy?
Thousands of years.
Yeah, thousands,
yes,
of years.
And they've researched every book.
Yes.
They've done, you know, the other time we were here with Jacob,
yes,
we told you we just came back from Colorado, Denver, yes, from the academic conference,
yes,
Academy of Religions. We met professors of learning, yes, theologians.
That's right.
Doctors of divinities,
mm-hmm,
doctors of mysteries. All of them were busy cogitating. But it's like what Shakespeare called much ado about nothing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And they run around in circles. Now, what is the core question? None of them has an answer. Everybody's guessing. So that conference made me appreciate the problem the Pharisees, the scribes, the Sadducees, the Herodians,
yes,
and all the leaders of thought of ancient Israel had. Because according to all their scriptures, the birth of the Christ, even if he's going to come through a woman, not in a goat shed,
yes,
where animals stay.
Not in a manger.
Not in a, yeah. He's supposed to be either in the house of the high priest, the chief priest,
yes,
or Herod himself, the king.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he made mistake and went to the house of Pilate, they could understand. But to be of a virgin, they said no intercourse, yeah, between the father and the mother, and he came to be one abnormality.
Yes.
He was not.
One abnormality. That's really funny. You know, you think about the thousands of years,
yeah,
of the prophecy about the coming of the Lord. Now we have another set of prophecies that have been going,
yes,
on,
mm-hmm,
for hundreds of years. But you have not talked to us about Colorado, your conference in Colorado.
We will.
Yeah.
Okay, when?
We will.
Because
let him pick,
okay,
up where he's going.
Uh-huh.
All right.
So now we say one abnormality. Number two, who is the father?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody. Because in this world today, hey, like one of these, their comedian, the young man, the teacher said, hey, son, you got to go to school because somebody said, no, not always. Say, how do you mean? He said, my brother told me before you make something in life, you must know somebody. Mm-hmm. He said, and which job does your brother have? He said, he ain't got no job because he ain't got nobody.
So now that's a very simple answer.
So you have to be somebody. But he made everything, like you said in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, right? He chose the foolish things of this world to confound the wisdom of the wise. He was born among animals, mm-hmm. of a virgin birth, mm-hmm. a possible plebeian, because Joseph is not of nobility. They cannot even trace his ancestry to Judah. He was poor. He cannot afford an inn. That is where the king of the universe manifested. And revealing himself, he went to far away Persia, mm-hmm. to reveal to some occult men, because we call them wise men. Yes.
Magician.
Yeah. Right now, if you mention such people, they say, no, those God cannot go.
Magician.
Then he went again to return the angels, not to the house of Herod, mm-hmm. or to the chief priests, yes. or the prophets of Israel, but to shepherds, yeah. in the bush.
Yes.
You see the wisdom of God.
Mm-hmm. Shepherds.
So Christ coming.
Man.
Yes, he came to lift the man in the lowest fallen state, and then cleanse us with his blood and present us before divinity,
yeah.
as those he has chosen, not because we chose him. That's why his birth and celebration is beyond religion.
Absolutely.
It really is. It makes you think, when you stop and think about the manger, mm-hmm. and the simpleness of it, mm-hmm. the light. There were no candles.
No.
There was a hay. There was no place to rest.
Let him read Micah chapter 5, verse 2.
Please
read.
Yeah.
Just a pair of read what he has said right now.
I got it. He said, but thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, uh-huh. though thou be little among the thousands of Judah, uh-huh. yet out of thee shall he come forth unto me, uh-huh. that is to be ruler in Israel, uh-huh. whose going forth have been from old,
yes.
from everlasting.
Exactly. You see how the prophecy is given. Pops a question. But thou, Bethlehem Ephratah, though you are the least,
the smallest,
yeah, the tiniest, mm-hmm. the poorest, the most despised, the most rejected, the ones that is not even on the map,
mm-mm.
though you are the least of all the princes in Judah, out of you the Christ will come.
Wow, what a powerful statement.
Yes.
Out of the least.
Yes. Out of the least.
I mean, you see that every day. I have to go back to the World Cup because some of the... I was fascinated with this whole thing of,
yes.
the world coming together and the preachings and the teachings that you've heard over the years. At least some of those players came from the slums,
yes.
mm-hmm.
of their cities.
Yes, absolutely.
And they will talk about it like it was, you know, just a bowl of soup. Mm-hmm. They will talk about their foods. And we've not only had the World Cup, but I guess you can tell I am a sports enthusiast, but I have a bunch of boys. But the same thing happened with the World Series.
Yes.
The guys that won the World Series, now we're talking Houston, Texas, were from the slums of the world,
mm-hmm.
some of them.
Yes.
But can you look at the greatest irony of all? There was somebody brought the two pictures of two countries, one in Africa, Morocco,
yeah.
one of the world powers, France.
Okay.
80% of French players were Africans.
It was so funny because I was on the phone with my cousin down in Houston, Texas. They watch our shows. And he was explaining to me why these players, when a microphone was not put in front of these players. I said, well, they should have interviewed him. He says, no. He doesn't speak English.
Mm-hmm.
He just plays ball.
Yes.
And I just think that's a world connection,
wow. mm-hmm.
of the prophecy that you're talking about.
Yes.
Today.
The thing that really hits or should hit home is returning to the root of the prophecy itself.
Yes.
Returning?
Everybody has to return to the word of God, to the prophecy itself.
Yes. Okay.
What does the prophecy say? Because that's what Israel missed.
We don't like prophecies. If we can't see it and touch it right now.
Yes, we don't want to hear.
We don't want to hear about it.
But what we see and touch is not prophetic. What is prophetic is what God has said will take place.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the only thing that really will come to pass.
But you know the challenge you have now?
Yes.
Humanity, in the name of technological advancement,
yeah.
has put themselves in another Pandora's box.
Yes.
You know what I mean? There's a video trending right now about a baby factory.
A what?
Baby.
Factory?
Yeah, where the man and the woman will bring their cells together, and in its something that looks like the womb generated artificially, it will fuse and germinate and start producing until you have the baby of your choice. Genetic coordination,
yeah,
every aspect, you know, man now is making themselves, that's like you said, now we have to connect ourselves back to the root, but they are more separating themselves because they are claiming to be God. And instead of solving the problem, what are we creating?
More problems.
More problems.
We're creating.
A
manufactured baby, right?
Exactly. Yes.
Where I can pick blonde and blue eyes, black hair, or
everything you want.
Pick it out.
Like Pablo Picasso, you paint the baby you want and reproduce it in a factory.
Let's read Isaiah chapter 9.
Okay, Isaiah 9. I want the bishops to repeat these because I know some of you are following us through your Bibles.
Yes.
And that is most important to this in pride. Matthew, again, please.
Isaiah. Chapter 9.
9.
Verses 6 and 7.
6 and 7.
The will read for us so that it will help the audience to look at what was given. The prophecy that we read just a minute ago in Micah was given 400 years before it actually took place.
400 years.
400 years.
Ooh.
You know, that is to say that the Christ will come, a virgin will bring forth the son, and Bethlehem is the village that it will come from. But Bethlehem, let's look in Dallas. Where can we compare in Dallas? You know, when we talk about the city of Dallas, for instance, you know, Plano, it's up there.
Plano.
You should go out of Dallas.
Cedar Hill is all the way down here.
Yes.
Just get out of Dallas. Go to the remote areas. I see you're on the way to Houston, somewhere around there.
So, no, it's not on the map. No one thinks
it's not on the. It's not on the map. Wait a minute. I just realized
it was on the map.
It was, that's right. It was.
It was not on the map then.
So we just don't know.
You don't, but it's there.
It's there. Okay.
Yes.
And even today, Nazareth is not even in Israel, somewhere in Syria. You cannot get there if you travel to Israel because you have to pass through Golan Heights.
Yes.
And Golan Heights is a DM zone, demilitarized zone.
DMZ zone.
Yes, you cannot. You cannot cross it to Nazareth.
We're looking at through.
Yes.
Always we try the technical back to the scriptures.
Yes, I had no idea.
Yes.
Well, most people don't have that idea. That's why you're so popular.
If you listen to the wise men, they're called wise not for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
They ask a question. Where is he that is born King of the Jews? If it was so easy to spot the place, they would have gone directly
of
to
course,
where
Herod wouldn't have known. They would go their way.
You understand?
Yes,
so
they were.
So they're now trying to locate the where, the place. Where is this place?
Mm-hmm.
Herod was a king.
Mm-hmm.
He really should be in a king's house.
Mm-hmm.
Bethlehem? Where is Bethlehem?
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Yes.
It's really funny because we anticipate one thing.
Yes.
Because God has spoken this thing.
That's right.
And you got to find it.
Even if you, beyond even the wise men, even when he started his work, in his own homeland, they don't know. When Philip met his friend Nathaniel, remember?
Mm-hmm.
He said, hey, my friend, we found him that is born, the one that has come to lead, King Jesus, the son of this. And he said, hey, where is he from? Say, Nazareth. He asked him one straightforward question. Hey, man, can anything good come out of Nazareth?
Mm-hmm.
So it is not believed to be a place where you have anything good.
It works against the odds, like you mentioned the World Cup.
Mm-hmm.
You would never expect this array of people to be on this stage, but now they are.
And all the big names are out.
Exactly.
All the big names are, and all the big sponsors are sponsoring them.
Uh-huh.
Yes. So it works irony. You know, the irony that God himself works, it shocks everybody. Mm-hmm. Everyone. Let's hear from Isaiah chapter 9.
Isaiah 9.
6 and 7, yes.
Say, for unto us a child is born.
Uh-huh.
Unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and he shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, mm-hmm. upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it,
yes.
and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. Mm-hmm. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
For unto us a child is born. Did you hear that? It doesn't say for unto us a child shall fly from the skies.
Mm-hmm.
So the scripture says, yes.
Among all of us.
Yes, among all of us. He's going to come like your son.
Grow up naturally.
Yes.
Make friends.
But no one pays attention. Today, we are 8 billion human beings upon the planet. Today, that's an awful lot of birth.
Yes.
And given by women all over the planet.
Mm-hmm.
That is.
Yes.
It's unimaginable.
From
the prophecy, I think, is what I'm focusing on right now. The prophecy was 400 years in company.
Yes.
And
nobody could say it.
Nobody.
And from different families.
We'll tell you why.
Why?
I want us, before we go to this subject, pause for a second and look at Paul gave the answer. And we want to give you the answer in the scriptures.
Okay.
Paul, before he became Paul, he was Saul, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he believed in the coming of Christ. But he believed in the coming of Christ not as per the written words of God, as per what he heard in the sanctuaries when he went to learn in the different denominations that existed. He was a Pharisee, one of the most popular denominations of the time.
And a lawyer.
Yes. It was a learned person.
A lawyer.
But Paul could not understand that it had been written that Christ will come out of Bethlehem from a virgin. That isn't being preached where he went. The expectation again was that Christ will return. First Elijah will return, Jairus of fire. And of course, Christ will return, not from where anybody would know. Obviously the clouds.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Then all of a sudden, the workings of God is made manifest. Christ is born in Bethlehem. He grows up like Paul Apostle grew up. Nobody expected him to come and grow up like anybody else.
For 33 years.
Yes, he was there.
Doing chores, washing dishes,
exactly.
Doing everything that
a kid does. The Bible writes about it. It says, the one that is the anointed one, the Christ, while yet he is like a little child, there shall be no difference between him and anybody else.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that's natural.
Yes.
Even in the royal palace, the prince,
yes.
the maids mark the prince when he misbehaves.
Yes.
While washing him in the tub,
they can slap him. Until the time appointed. Yes.
I bet not very many people take them up on that.
But
because you don't just slap a prince. In fact,
yes.
you really don't really hit anybody else's child. Back to disagreements.
I know.
We have come to the point now, I cannot hit my neighbor's kid.
But still,
yes.
Even if you like, put a searchlight. The royalty said they are so busy.
Mm.
Hey, get my son ready for the banquet. He start playing the usual pranks. Hey, Junior, come here, behave yourself.
Yes.
And he gets dressed up,
mm-hmm.
but when he gets to a certain age yes. and assumes his position, that same maid cannot serve him a glass of water without going on her knees.
Correct. Yes.
Because the prince or whoever, while still a child, yes. is like every other child.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, when fortune favors you, okay, look at Jack Ma, the one of the billionaires from China, remember?
What's his name again?
Jack Ma. M-A.
Jack Ma.
Now,
okay.
When he showed his background as a child, he came from a very poor environment.
Yes.
When you talk of the type of poverty one has, and uh-huh. the poor people call you a poor person. That is poverty, uh-huh. the poorest of the poor. But today he's among the richest men on earth. Upon him was a crown of wealth, but he came from nowhere.
Wow.
So the same thing, when Christ came, he had to come from the nobodies. Because if he came from the nobility
right. yes.
and the elites, he would not have compassion for the nobodies.
And the message would have been the same.
Yes, and the prophet called him a man of sorrows, acquainted
with grief.
He understood the pain of humanity. He understood the journey we are making, our roadway. How did we get to where we are? What were our experiences?
Wow.
So he had to take it along himself, and he can never gain any knowledge without experience. He experienced it firsthand, so that when he takes up rulership,
knowledge without experience,
he will be able now to discern in judgment.
Hold that point. I've got to take a little bit of a break. I have been asked to take a break.
Yes.
And that's, so we're going to take a little bit of a break with bishops. The twin bishops on yesterday's show. You can tell they're twins. They both look alike. We'll be right back. Go away. Wow. That is just, it's just amazing. Especially that prophecy. Of a discussion about the birth of Christ.
Yes.
And I'm reminded of all of the scriptures that we've so talked about, Corinthians, Matthew, Micah,
yes.
Ezra, and all of the education that you're getting about the Bible and the 400 years of prophecy now. How do we wrap this up?
Now, if we go to Isaiah chapter 63.
Okay, 63.
Yes, from verses 1 through 4. You will see that the Father showed to the same Isaiah that after Christ will come out of Israel and shed his precious blood, that he will return to judge the world and he will come out of Edom.
Edom?
Edom, yes. From the city of Bosra. Now, just as the people of... Yes?
I think it will be better. You know, when he said Edom, I read something in her face. Like, hey, where is that coming from?
You read it right.
Yeah.
I haven't heard that before.
Yeah. Edom is the first son of Isaac.
Yes.
You know, Isaac had two sons, remember, before his grace will continue.
Mm-hmm.
When God made the promise to Abraham, he told him that through his generation shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Now Ishmael, he told him that he will have 12 princes, he will be a great man, but a restless man that will not know give peace or have peace. But he still dwell among his brethren. So what is happening in the world today is already prophesied, even with our brothers of Islamic faith. It's in God. Yes. Then Isaac had two sons, Jacob, who is called Israel, and Esau, who is called Edom. But instead of the glory to be given to the first son, Esau, it was given to the second son, Jacob, who is Israel. But the father promised him that the time shall come when the yoke shall be broken from off his neck and dominion shall return to him. So the blessings of God is not only to the house of Jacob alone, but it started from the house of Jacob so that the first son, who is Edom, will laugh last and laugh forever. So please, sir, go ahead.
Thank you.
Isaiah chapter 63.
Yes.
Tells us about the return of Christ, the second coming of Christ. So all the brethren listening online, the pastors, the churches, the Christians, the Muslims, please open your scriptures to Isaiah chapter 63.
Could you read for us? Yeah. Who is this that cometh from Edom?
Did you hear that?
Yes.
With dyed garments from Bozrah. Mm-hmm. This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength, said, I, that speak in righteousness, mighty to save.
Yes.
So wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, and thy garments like unto him that treadeth the winefat?
Yes.
He said, I have trodden the winepress alone, and of the people there was none with me. For I will tread them in mine anger, and trample them in my fury, and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments, and I will stain on my raiment. For the day of vengeance is in mine heart, and the year of my redeemed is come.
Thank you for that.
Thank you.
And now, to hear more, to read more about this, you can now dial into the Everlasting
Gospel.
I think the QR code will be on the screen.
It's on the screen already.
Are we getting to the app?
Yes. I think everyone into the app immediately.
Because the app brings us fully into the 21st century.
That is correct.
And I'm impressed that churches and synagogues and teachings don't get more into the technology that is available to us.
We have to.
They have no choice, because it is written that all eyes shall see, all ears shall hear.
Mm-hmm.
So every technology given to man is given to God by God for a reason. Though in some instances we abuse it, but the original plan of God can never be out. So the technology he gave now, so that wherever you are, in whichever part of the earth you reside, this message of hope, you can access this app he's talking about, the Everlasting Gospel app. You know, you talk about our little book.
Yes.
You get all this and more.
You remember this, right?
You know, I have a little bit of a problem. I was given a copy of the book.
Yes.
And most Bibles you would write in, but for some reason I can't write a word in that Bible. I don't know if I think it's going to disintegrate or if it's going to. What's going to happen if I write in it? And I actually have one of my mother's Bibles, and it's just something that Jacob picked up.
Yeah.
And he said, oh, is this their book? And he just loved it because it was heavy.
Yes.
It's light reading.
Yes.
So Jacob is my grandson. He's not, he's named after the one in the Bible.
Yes.
But I have not written one word in that Bible other than the inscription that you did for me.
Thank you.
Wow.
But it is so beautiful, but I do read it.
Yes.
But that, I do remember the book. And it is called The Everlasting Gospel.
Gospels, yes.
And it gets your full attention because it's red. Very red.
Now we have come full circle worldwide.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Just as what happened 2,000 years ago.
Yes.
It's repeating itself clockwork. Mm-hmm. In the scriptures, you will read, God said to Isaiah and showed to him that he will come out of Edom from Bozrah to execute judgment, vengeance. What are we doing today all over the world? Just like the people of the old, we are once again looking up the clouds for Christ to come.
Mm-hmm.
But our Bible, each Bible on the planet, all the scriptures tells us that Jehovah God, the Christ of God, is coming out of Edom. And just as our forefathers paid no attention to the scriptures,
tried.
Once again, we are not paying any attention to the scriptures. May God help us to redirect us back into the scriptures.
Amen. And if you look at one mystery of the scripture, as Isaiah said in the past, that a virgin shall conceive and be with child.
Yes.
Ironically, this time around, it was Jesus Christ himself that prophesied it.
Yes.
Because in Revelation 19, verse 10, it said the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in Revelation 12, verse 5 precisely, let not even start from verse 1.
Really?
Yeah, he gave a prophecy of another birth of another ruler who is coming to execute judgment.
Correct.
You got it, sir? Yes, sir.
Sure. Revelation chapter 12.
Ah, my favorite. Revelation.
Revelation 12, verse 5. And she brought forth a man child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up unto God and to his throne. May the Father bless his holy word.
Amen. Can you understand the difference? Now, the first one said a virgin.
Yes.
God does not repeat himself.
Yes.
Because every other woman will feel, oh, because I'm not a virgin, I'm not useful
right.
to God. Eh?
Right.
But this time it's a woman, because the woman came out of the man and the man came out of the woman. So they are symbiotic. So now the woman bringing forth a child, the one that's to sit on the throne, is he not the judge?
Yes.
Yeah.
What is Isaiah chapter 63 he could give us earlier say? That he's coming to execute judgment.
Yes.
You know, so that the will of God, because the prayer Christ taught us, he didn't come to set up Christianity
yes.
or any religion.
He told us that before.
Yes.
It's true.
Matthew
yeah.
chapter 6 verse 10, he said, thy kingdom come.
Talk about the kingdom.
Everywhere. He said, when you go, tell them the kingdom of God is now with you.
Yes.
He said, the kingdom of God, he never, because religion was made by man.
It is.
And all of their brothers, we've got so many religions now,
yes.
we don't know if... I mean, it's just too many.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But God is one.
Yes.
And when we come into God, the only religion God knows is love.
Yes. Love one another.
As I have loved you.
Yes.
Period.
Love thy neighbor.
Love thy neighbor.
Just love thy neighbor.
Not thy religion.
Yeah,
not thy religion.
Right. That is such a profound...
Yes.
And people pick that up as though it is the gospel, but that's what we should be talking about during this holiday season.
Yes.
What are your last words to us for the holiday?
Celebrate Christ by loving one another
oh.
in practical terms. And that's what we all have to do.
That's
all. What he came to do. He showed us love.
Mm-hmm.
Pure love and practical love. And that's what the leader of brotherhood, leader Olumba
mm-hmm.
Ogun insists. He says, don't call me anything. I want all of us to love
one another.
Love
finish.
Yes. White
it
man, love black man. Black man, love white man. Christian,
period.
Muslim, the whole world.
Come together.
Love one another, for we are one brother.
Simple. And just one word. That love brings the twin brother.
Yes.
Forgiveness.
Mm-hmm. Forgiveness.
Forgive one another. Did you know
that?
Because Christ, even that was how he confirmed his mission.
Yes.
The Holy Father said, if he had not done that,
yes.
he wouldn't have become the King
if
of Kings.
If you have not done that.
If Christ
yes.
said, when he said, Father,
yeah.
please forgive man, for he did not know what he's doing. Because a lot of people will offend you out of ignorance.
Yeah.
And if you must take vengeance in every act done against you, love will take the back seat and leave you alone.
Yes.
But forgiveness opens the way for love and
mm-hmm.
brings peace and progress. That
progress.
Is the key thing
progress.
For this season. So
as
that
we go
grow
into
higher.
The season, all of the families that are not speaking to each other. What
yes.
do you think about that?
Reconcile. They must reconcile.
Who makes the first call? How do you do that?
It's really easy. In fact, the Father has a specific gospel of it. If you go into the app, go to the gospel of
okay.
what,
go
what
to the app.
Cross.
What is cross, eh?
Yes. You, if your brother offends you, okay, and you know that he is wrong, you that are not wrong, you are now the one to go to him.
And say, I'm sorry.
Yes, it is you. For the cross of peace.
And it doesn't mean you're weak if you turn the other cheek.
Yes.
It takes strength of character.
You have to have the spirit of God
to accommodate.
Well, you heard it from the bishops themselves.
Yes.
The
yes.
twin bishops, the only ones in the world on yesterday's show. And we want you to have a happy, happy holiday.
Thank
of course,
you.
Watch our shows, share our shows, and go to the app.
Yes.
And you know what? You know what? You really are the greatest audience in the world.
Thank
I'll see you.
You
next time. Thank
All
you.
Right. Thank you.